is going to be playing a piece by Eugene Boza, very popular composer, both the saxophone and the clarinet. And do you know anything about Mr. Boza? Has your teacher mentioned any facts? I think it's always kind of neat to find out a little bit about the background of. That's okay. If not, I put him on the spot and not mean to. Mr. Boza has written many, many pieces for saxophone clarinet, particularly for Marcel Mew, who was one of our, I would say, fathers of the saxophone from the middle part of the 20th century. And this particular piece is really a piece that's based on the music of Bach. It was really used for a tonal study and a study to be able to sort of figure out where our phrases lead and just for good melodic playing. And this is the aria of Eugene Boza, and let's see what you do. Let me just move the chairs.
A little tired?
Yeah.
It sure didn't seem it, though. I thought you played with terrific air support. This is a piece that is very taxi on the air, and we get a little hent up with what we call bad air, but I thought you handled the air quite well in that. And finding places to exhale if you're playing this piece is the trick. We can always find a place to take a breath in, but to exhale that breath is very difficult. There's one thing I'd like to talk, there's a couple things I'd like to focus on. First, you have a terrific sound. I really love the sound. And I think it's very indicative of a good saxophone teaching. Your teacher, I know your teacher very well. He was a student here, so mine. And you have your teacher's sound, and that's terrific. You're listening very, very well. And secondly, you have a nice sense of musical line, a nice sense of pace. And we're going to work a little bit on maybe trying to develop a longer line. Thirdly, and probably the topic we talked about first was the air. Making sure that we get as deep of a breath and relaxed breath as possible. And that whenever we take the breath, that it's not, okay, it's not two stages. It's one continuous stage. It's inhale, exhale. When you walk down the street, you don't think, breath in, breath out. We're the natural respiration. And in this case, too, I think that's very important when taking a breath. So, and what I like to suggest is when I get really, shall we say, bad air stuck inside of me, think of how, the syllable how, or ho, what. So think of as low as possible, taking that breath in and making sure it's always there. Okay, so that's just one little aspect. The second thing I'd like to visit and really spend a little more time on is your line. Now, as we said, this piece is based on some of the music on and some of the passages of Bach. And you can hear a little bit of Bach here, can't you?
Yeah.
In the line. And oftentimes, when I am trying to figure out where is the line leading us, where am I trying to direct the phrase? What is the point I'm trying to make to my audience musically? You know, I have this phrase and this phrase, this phrase and this phrase, and they all need to hear. If you're giving a lecture, you're suggesting something about one, two, three, four, and finally you give the answer to the four questions that you're asking your audience to consider or to ponder. And the same type of thing here, I would leave the line more to these longer notes. That's really the first two large phrases that we should consider. So think about, and think about leading to those lines by stretching slightly and playing into the notes prior to those quarters.
Okay.
talking about those four notes up there that are the outline. Where I might lead to the upper of those four notes. Can you play exactly like that? Has a little bit of depth. You know, we're sort of showcasing a little bit of the architecture of the phrase or the landscape of the phrase. Now, as you're beating into that upper note, let the sound expand just a little bit and don't rush it back. Okay? Push it. Slightly stretching and creating anticipation for the audience to enjoy those beautiful moments. Okay? I think you're doing very well. A couple of final things. At the end, it comes back. The form is, it starts with this beautiful melody and it develops and it comes back and restates the beginning. And with that, it says triple pianissimo. One thing you could do is take the vibrato and not show it at the end. In other words, play with no vibrato. So it's almost like a remembrance. Let's try that, just coming in from the end here, right there, okay? I'm sorry.
I know the saxophone is a close-hold instrument, but still, you have to think about your legato. It's all something, you know,
don't really want to hear it, you know, when your fingers move. So you want to think about keeping them very legato, and the way to do that is to keep the wind flowing all the time. Okay? But I think you have a really lovely sense of the piece, and it, just as he said, it's very nice. And are you a senior?
Junior.
Okay, very cool. Thank you.
Evan is from Ludington, right?
Ludington. Ludington.
So nice to have you come down and play so well for us.
Very nice.
See you soon. Thank you.